President Rodrigo Duterte slams the Philippine Center for Investigative Journalism, or PCIJ, for probing his family's wealth.
Wag na kami, kasi kami, what we earned outside is none of your business, actually. Yung, ano na, may mga negosyo kami, may mga law office kami. What a goddamn shit.
The PCIJ says the law firm Carpio and Duterte Lawyers, ran by Duterte's daughter Sarah and her husband Man Scarpio, has not been registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission since it was founded 10 years ago. The PCIJ also reports big spikes in the net worth of Duterte and his children while in public office. Duterte credits his late mother Soledad Roa Duterte for his wealth.
Putang ina ninyo. Hoy! Yung mga dilaw, all the time I was with my mother. Baskin na noong mayor na ako, ang nagpapakain sa akin, nanay ko. Yung nanay ko ang may pera. Yun ang nanay ko nag-iwan ng pera sa amin. Pero kung magkano, eh bakit sabihin ko sa inyo?
Duterte has flip-flopped on the origins of his wealth. He used to say in campaign speeches his family started out poor in Davao City. But in 2017, Duterte said his late father, former Davao Governor Vicente Duterte, left them an inheritance. Davao del Norte 2nd District Representative Tonyboy Floirendo Jr. is vying for the House Speakership. Floirendo announces his decision on Facebook Monday. He says, quote, "I want to unite the lower house in fully backing the Duterte administration to realize its dreams for the Filipino people in the three remaining years." Floirendo is a major contributor to Duterte's 2016 presidential campaign. He donated 75 million pesos, the biggest amount that came from a single donor. House Speaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo is on her last term. Duterte earlier expressed public support for the speakership bid of Marinduque Representative Lord Alan Velasco. But his daughter Sarah also referred to former later Representative Martin Romualdez as the next speaker. Former Foreign Secretary Alan Peter Cayetano also claimed Duterte supports his bid to be speaker. Floirendo, in his statement, also claims ousted Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez wants to reclaim the post. Floirendo and Alvarez are now foes after the former speaker accused Floirendo of graft. The Immigration Bureau brands as fake news the story of how social media personality Xian Gaza evaded airport clearance to leave the country. Gaza posted on Facebook the story of how he was able to leave the country with three warrants of arrest and a five-year sentence back in 2018. Immigration spokesperson Dana Sandoval clarifies there were no warrants of arrest when Gaza left. There were no whole departure orders either. Sandoval says it was quite uneventful and ordinary, really. No Hollywood-level storyline, just regular immigration clearance. She adds the Bureau is studying possible actions against Gaza. Gaza was convicted for 11 counts of violating the bouncing check law in June 2018. He first came to the public eye when he asked actress Erich Gonzalez on a date via a billboard. New Zealand's privacy regulator John Edwards on Monday accuses Facebook of failing to cooperate on live streaming issues in the wake of the Christchurch mosque's massacre. The Christchurch gunman live streamed his rampage at two mosques on March 15 on Facebook, with the footage spreading rapidly online despite the platform saying it quickly removed the footage. Edwards says Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg was disingenuous in saying bad actors were going out of their way to circumvent Facebook's systems. Zuckerberg said last week a delay on live feeds was not on the cards despite pressure to crack down on the sharing of violent video or images. Edwards adds Facebook needs to step up and be responsible for the content it hosts. Australia last week passed controversial laws that could jail social media executives from Facebook and YouTube for failing to take down violent extremist content quickly. K-pop group TWICE is coming to Manila. Known for the songs Cheer Up and Titi, the girls confirm on social media that they would bring their TWICE World Tour to the Philippines on June 29. The group is scheduled to release their seventh mini-album called Fancy You on April 22.